Yo, what up? So I decided to make a Hand Showdown weapon tier list to show you what weapons I like, what I don't like, what I think about them. But I just need to point out this is only my tier list, so it's not gonna be a good tier list for people in general. This is just what guns do I prefer and what do I think about them. So first you got the Bomb Blends, okay? Bomb Blends, if I was on console, I would put S tier or A tier, but on PC it's kinda B tier because in the PvP it's not great, but you can easily farm meatheads. I guess that's the best part with the bomb blends and kill bosses, of course. But I think it's like middle, you know? It's not bad, it's not good against players, of course. So next, you got Bornheims, all three. Well, I don't use Bornheim that much, but it can be a really good weapon for headshots, for spamming headshots. It has like really small recoil, so I think I would put all Bornheims A tier. But usually when I play Bornheim, I pair it with the Winfield so I get more ammo for it. But yeah, I think all Bornheims are A tier, because there is not really a big difference between them, right? Okay, chain pistol. With Fanning, chain pistol is D, okay? With Fanning, chain pistol is D, but it's still a conversion pistol. Still can headshot, so I would put it C. It's not the useless weapon, you know? I think D is like the useless weapon. It's pretty good, you know, but with the Fanning, I don't know. I'm not a fan of Fanning anyway, so yeah. Okay, we got the conversion. Conversion, I think it's. Is the uppercut? No, that's conversion, okay. So conversion is of course better than chain for Fanning, and you know less weight than Fanning, so that's straight upgrade for me. So I put it on B. Then we have the uppercut. Okay, a lot of people think I'll put uppercut S tier, A tier. I might put it A tier, but definitely not S tier because with recent changes, I don't quick switch as much as before, and most of the fights happen at closer range anyway. So I do need Uppercut when you can just play Dolch or most unit are on Sharpshooter, you know what I mean? So it's still a good weapon, but I would put it A tier, I think. Okay, we got the packs. If I could do double packs, it would definitely be S tier, yeah? Double packs would be S tier. But I'm not gonna do that because there is no option. But packs, it's B tier. I think it's like on the same level as conversion, you know, pistol. Does a little bit more damage, but not sure. For me, I am for the headshots anyway, so doesn't really matter that much. Okay, we got the rifle. The rifle is my favorite shotgun. So that's A tier. I just prefer the rifle over Romero because, you know, two shots, and I usually like rush into people, so I don't have time to reload, so two shots is like really good for me, you know. So now we got the rival hand cannon. Well, medium slot shotguns are really bad, so I'll put it on C. Because if you play double Lemat, if you didn't know, Lemat shotgun has the same stats as the rival shotgun, rival hand cannon shotgun. So if you wanna play rival hand cannon, you just take double Lemat and it's gonna be the same damage, same spread, same everything. Plus you'll have the compact ammo, right? Okay, so we got Saber. Saber is actually, I would say, B tier. Because it's small slot and it's like one of the best melee small slot, you know? Okay, we got X. Okay, I'm sorry, but I need to put X on D as being useless. It's large, no, it's medium slot. Okay, it's medium slot, but still. You can find the X in Ward. So there is no reason to take it as your loadout. You cannot even throw it, you know. So yeah, that's D tier as being useless for me. Explosive crossbow can be fun. It's not really good. You need to headshot or body shot in order to kill. So that's a C for me. Normal crossbow, okay. Also C. I'm not fan on crossbows, yeah, because the time they need to reload is pretty bad. Plus, you know, slow bolts and the switching. Oh my god. You need to wait so long to switch the weapon. So that makes it really, really bad for me at the moment. Maybe it will change with the custom ammo, you know, they'll add more bolts. But shot bolt? Shot bolt is definitely, I would say A tier, because basically you have unlimited range for one tap. So it's way better than other crossbows. Okay, we got a crown. The crown is, I would say, B tier for me, even though I like it way more before, but it kind of let me down, because usually when I fight with crown, I just, for some reason, I just spam and miss all the shots. The recoil actually kills me. Okay, we got dodge. I don't need to talk about this, I think. It's the best. That's it. Hand crossbow. Okay. Hand crossbow is D tier, because it's medium slot and it's just bad, you know. You can just use Romero and it will perform better. Maybe if they make it small slot, it would be useful, I guess. But at the moment, it's medium slot, pretty bad. Lapel for me, many people will disagree, but I think it's B tier for me, because in general I don't like the sights. That's it. And the bullet pickup rate, you just loot the big rate and you get like 2 or 1 bullet, which is kinda bad. On the other hand, double marksman, definitely S tier. It's like the best sniper in the game, and I think it's a bit overpowered, because you can shoot really fast with it, faster than anything else basically. It's like Winfield, but long ammo, and you have scope for it, so it's definitely OP for me. Yeah, Lebel Talon, same thing. Same as Lebel, basically. I don't really use the Talon, and I don't notice the extra sway on the Talon, so it's same for me. Lemat is kind of good weapon, even though I don't use it much. I think it's B tier, because, of course, the shotgun, and small slot shotgun is pretty good. Okay, we got Machete. I would say definitely D tier, because you can just like, you can take a knife and have more range for melee, you know, and knife is 2 slot. So I don't think you should ever waste your weapon slot for this, okay? Okay, we got the Martini Henry Deadeye. I don't really like, because of the bullet speed is 410, I think, same as uppercut. So both the scoped version, I would put at C tier. But the normal Martini, it can be pretty good, so I put it on B tier, just because it doesn't have scope, and I like the sights of this. There is nothing blocking the sights. It's, you know, pretty nice. The Martini Henry Ripple Sight, yeah? That's definitely B tier also. It can be really good, and I think it's like the best bayonet version for the large slot weapon, you know? Actually, yeah, I'll put it on A tier. Mosin Obrez Drum. Well, for me, I don't use this weapon at all, because why play Obrez when you can play large slot Mosin, right? And this extra sway on it is really bad. So I put it on D tier. Okay, we got the Aftomat. The Aftomat. Okay, for most people, I would put B, but for me, I kind of know how to play with it, so I put it on A. Okay. There is gonna be upcoming Fronky guide with Aftomat. You need to see it, because if you know how to play with Aftomat, it can be really good, okay? Even though it's RNG, you still have like 15 bullets with long ammo automatic, so if you control the spray and if you know how it works, it's you will destroy it with it, you know? Okay, we got the Mosin Bayonet here. I don't play the Bayonet, so actually let's put a B tier for me. Because the Bayonet, I can see the increase of the sway when I play Bayonet, but the normal version, definitely A tier. The Obrez is pretty nice, even though I don't use it, but it can be, if you play it with shotgun, it can be really good, because, you know, you're gonna shoot with Obrez, people are gonna think you have large slot motion, so they're gonna push you, but then you have shotgun, so if you can play it with shotgun, it's definitely better than C tier. This is just for me, because I don't really play it, you know. Okay, then we got the Obrez Mace. Well, same, the sway is too high, so yeah, it's D tier for me. This way is just too hard, and the mace is not even good. Okay, the Mosin Sniper. I think it's the same A tier. It's like, you have the sniper scope, 5 bullets, but level marksman is better, like, in every way, so. Okay, the Nagant Officer Brawler. Of course, it's exactly the same as Officer, I would say. It has exactly the same stats, just a bit upgrade, you know, with the dusters, but it's still like one of the best weapons. So I would put A tier, both of them. If you think about the price, it's like 66, and you know, it can two tap people. Okay, my favorite weapon, I mean, it was my favorite weapon. Did my gun precision the die? 8 tier, for sure. People think this is a meme weapon, but the weapon has no recoil, and you can shoot pretty fast if you buy the perks. The carbine the die. Well, people would say this is like S tier, you know? But for me, I cannot handle the recoil on it. So for me it goes C tier. Same goes for the normal one. Put it on C because just cannot handle the recoil, and I think you will do better with the officer. Okay, the Nagant pistol. Well, it's D tier for me. Like, there is no reason to use it for me because, you know, prestige 100, $1 million. So it's like starter weapon, okay? Once you use it, there is no reason to use it. Even though maybe with Fanning it can be good, but I don't like it. On the other side, we got the Nagant precision, which is this weapon, just with precision, with the stock. I would put it actually, let's put it B tier. The weapon has again no recoil, and it's shooting pretty fast, so you can just spam headshots. Well, actually I'm gonna put it A tier. It's like one of my favorite weapons for headshots. Okay, we got the Nagant silencer. It's same, again it's the same Nagant, but it's silenced, and that makes it way better than this, okay? Silenced weapon with good sights like this, it can be like really good, you know? So yes, that's B for me. I really like it, and it's satisfying. Okay, we got the Nitro Express rifle. I think I would put it on B. This weapon requires skill to use, but still it has like one tap range up to 43 meters. Then you can headshot up to 250. The Romero hand cannon is like the best medium slot shotgun, even though all of them are kinda bad. This one is kinda usable. This one is kinda good because the other shotguns, they have like so bad spread, but this one is really tight spread, so that's a B for me. Romero hand cannon hatchet. Well, I never kinda used, like, if you have melee attached to the shotgun, I don't know, man, I never used it, you know. So I put it on C. It has like worse spread, and I don't think it's worth taking the hatchet over the bad spread, so that's a C for me. Okay, we got the Romero and the Romero Talon. They are both really good shotguns, but it's only one shot, and I usually like rush into teams with the shotgun, so there is like, for me, there is no time to reload. I put it B tier, even though it's a really nice weapon. Okay, we got the Sparks. People would say I would put Sparks on S or A, but I'm gonna put it actually B, because after the quick switch nerf, I think the Sparks got nerfed the most. If you aim for body shots, why would you use a Sparks, right? You can just use Mosin, which will two tap really fast, and if you wanna go for headshots, you can still use Mosin because the muzzle velocity is faster, so the headshot should be easier. If the Sparks silencer had good sights, I would put it B tier, but because of the sights, I put it C tier, because I just cannot use the sights. That's why I prefer Nagant silencer way more than other silence weapons, so yeah, because of the sights, that's C tier for me. Spark sniper. Well, it's the same, B for me. If you wanna snipe, like, this is probably the most satisfying sniper, but the better snipers are, of course, Level Marksman, and Mosin Sniper is also way better in everything. Okay, the Spectre Bayonet. Well, again, I don't need melee on my shotguns, so for this is just straight downgrade from the Big Spectre for me. The Big Spectre is B tier for me, same as the Romero. The range is like smaller by 2 meters, and I just don't need a knife on my shot. Okay, now we got the Dennis weapon, aka Spectre Compact. Well, that's D tier for me. Like, it's meme weapon. I don't think it's like, if you wanna play shotgun, like seriously, you should never take this. Best medium slot shotgun is definitely the Romero. Okay, the Springfield Compact that I never use it. That's a D tier for me. I don't really like it, you know? This way is too big for me. And okay, the Springfield Compact, it's D tier for me also. This way is just too big for me, and same with the Compact Striker. D tier for me. Okay, the Springfield Marksman. I don't use it at all, because, you know, Springfield is like starter weapon, so it's C. Like, it can be good, you know, like if you like sniping and you prestige, it can be really good. But, you know, there is much better other stuff you can play, so the normal Springfield also C tier. It's like, it's starter weapon, but you can still headshot with it, right? So it's not that bad. I'm gonna put it B tier, because the same thing I did with the Martini snipers, so I'm gonna do it with the Springfield. Okay, we got the Betterly here. So some people think Wetter is kind of bad at the moment, but I find it like really, really good. The normal one up to B tier, even though if you play it with Iron Sharpshooter, you can shoot really fast with it. It's like, it's almost like Vinnie fire, right? And the damage is pretty huge. You can two tap people up to like 60 something meters. Same with the, I don't notice like any sway difference between those two, so it's basically the same weapon for me. And the bonnet, I kinda use it sometimes. But the Wetter Deadeye, I think it's A tier, because with the scope, with the traits, you can shoot super fast, and I like the Deadeye scope a lot, so for me it's A tier. It has like 167 headshot range. It can be used at any range, honestly. Okay, and the last, the Winfields. The Winfield Swift. S tier. It's S tier for me. And I think Winfield Swift is the best weapon in the game, if I don't count Dolch right now. Because you have the levering, yeah? And levering is good at like up to 30 meters. It can be pretty accurate. Plus you have the headshot range, like 100 meters. 96 or 95, I don't know. So I think it's like the best weapon in the game at the moment. Most of the fights happen under 100 meters anyway, so in 90% of the fights you will have, you'll use it in effective range, so it's S tier for me, definitely. Okay, the other Winfields. So, Vinnie Marksman. The gun has so much potential, but for some reason, it shoots slower than normal Vinnie in Iron Sight. So that's why I put it B tier, because I just cannot use it with the timing, you know? I'm used to shoot with Winfield, with Iron Sight, at a certain timings, but if I do the timings on this weapon, it does nothing. So the fire rate is slower for some reason if you are in the scope. Okay, the Winfield C version, I think, A tier, like you still have 8 bullets, but it's the same as Swift, but a bit worse. Okay, this is the Vinnie Silencer. Vinnie Silencer is C tier for me. It has the same muzzle velocity as Nagant Silencer, just bit more headshot range, but the sights make it really bad. And the levering, I guess you can use that, but if you wanna use levering with Silencer, you need to be close, so why not use the big Winfield, the better Winfield, you know, with the Swift. Okay, now the Vinnie Talon. So I don't think you need melee for Winfield, you can just use levering, so that makes it B tier for me, I guess. Okay, the Vinnie Musket. The Musket could be good if they increase the muzzle velocity a bit. It would be A tier. But at the moment, like, there is not really a reason to use it instead of Vinnie Swift, because it's like slower levering. Most of the people don't like the sight, so I would be B tier. That's for me. Okay, the Vinnie Aperture. Well, It's the same as normal Vinnie, honestly, so that's A tier, even though I don't count it as using the aperture, you know, because most of the time you will not use it. It's the same as the base variant, basically. So yeah, the base variant is the same, A tier. And now, Vinnie Vandal. Well, Vinnie Vandal Deadeye, D tier, because that gun has so much sway, the levering is so bad. You'll do better if you use Nagant Precision Deadeye. Like, it's almost the same, just this. Even the fire rate, I think the fire rate is faster for this weapon. Or maybe not, I don't know. But the sway is just too huge on it and there is not really a reason to use it. On the other hand, Vinnie Vandal, it's B tier for me. Both of them actually. Just because of the sway. The sway is like non-existent. I don't know why, but this way is the same as the big Winfields, so that's why I put it B tier. I mean, actually it's A tier, both of them. It has like no downside to the big Winfield, so it might be even better than the big Winfield. It's just the sights, you know, they are a bit thicker, so it's kinda harder to aim at long range. But this way is the same, headshot range, muzzle velocity is the same, so that's definitely A tier for me. Okay, I think like this it's complete, and that's my final choice of weapons at the moment. I did this before the custom ammo comes, because the custom ammo will change some weapons, I think, if I use it. But this is like without custom ammo, this is normal ammo, and this is like how I play. What weapon I like, what I don't like. I know many people would put like carbine higher, but I just don't like it because of the recoil, so most people will not agree. But this is what I play, you know, as being prestige hundred with like a lot of money. So there is no reason for me to use low tier weapons, because I can just buy the expensive ones. But yeah, you can tell me in comments what do you think, and if you agree or if you not agree. And thanks for watching.